Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The word of God continued to spread and grow. After Barnabas and Saul completed their relief mission, they returned to Jerusalem, taking with them John, who is called Mark. Now, there were in the church at Antioch prophets and teachers: Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who was a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and sent them off. So they, sent forth by the Holy Spirit, went down to Seleucia and from there sailed to Cyprus. When they arrived in Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in the Jewish synagogues. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May God have pity on us and bless us. May he let his face shine upon us. So may your way be known upon earth, among all nations, your salvation.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the nations be glad and exult, because you rule the peoples in equity. The nations on the earth you guide.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear him.
O God, let all the nations praise you. Please stand.
The light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me believes not only in me, but also in the one who sent me. And whoever sees me sees the one who sent me. I came into the world as light, so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. And if anyone hears my words and does not observe them, I do not condemn him, for I did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. Whoever rejects me and does not accept my words has something to judge him. The word that I spoke, it will condemn him on the last day, because I did not speak on my own, but the Father who sent me commanded me what to say and speak. And I know that his commandment is eternal life. So what I say the Father, I say as the Father told me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
It is good that we do not only see our vocations bilang pari, bilang mga magulang sa mga tumugon sa buhay relihiyoso at relihiyosa at sa mga madaming bokasyon at pagtawag po sa ari sa atin as God calling only or God calling per se. Natatawag lang ang Diyos at matapos tumawag ang Diyos, tutugon tayo. But there is also one beautiful phase or one beautiful thing when we talk about the Lord calling someone. And that is, He sets that person apart. Ibinubukod at kung nananaisin po natin gamitin ng salitang ito, itinatangi. Ang pagbubukod po ay gawain po natin araw-araw. Sa katapusan po, tatanggapin po ninyo ang inyong mga sweldo kung kayo po ay nagtatrabaho. Sa katapusan, kayo po ay magbubukod para sa kuryente, para sa pagkain, para sa bahay, para sa mga maliliit nating mga luho sa buhay na ito. You do setting apart for a purpose. But you know, God would not set apart someone for nothing. Hindi nagbubukod ang Diyos at nagsasantabi para wala siyang kalagyan. God sets apart someone for a purpose. We set apart someone for a purpose. Our first reading today recalls the story of the two disciples, Barnabas and Saul, being set apart and being sent by the Lord. The Lord sets them apart for the work God has called them to do. Ibinubukod at itinatangi para gampanin ang isang makadiyos at isang makaligtas na gawain para sa bayan ng Diyos. And my dear brothers and sisters, hopefully this is something that we are all grateful for in this life. That whenever God calls us to a particular event or a particular reason, it is not for us to be set aside, but to be on purpose. Lahat tayo ay tinatawag at ibinubukod ng Diyos sa ating mga iba't ibang kagampanin sa buhay na ito. Ibinukod ako ng Diyos para maging pari. Ibinukod ang Diyos ng marahil madami sa atin to be a mother or a father. Iba't ibang mga kalagayan sa buhay. With who and where we are, we always feel the Lord setting us apart. Not to disregard us, but to fire us up and help us do our mission and our purpose in life. And this is what Jesus Himself said in our Gospel. He Himself was set aside by His Father to be the light in this world, to give life in this world, and to be the love and the face of His Father here on earth. Itinatangi para sa isang magandang layunin. My dear brothers and sisters, whoever and wherever we are, God sets us apart not to disregard us, but to lead us to our purpose. Hindi tayo binubukod ng Diyos para hindi tayo pansinin ng Diyos o hindi din tayo pansinin ng mundo. Bagkus, ang bawat tawag ay pagtatangi sa atin. para mas palakasin tayo sa buhay na ito at maging maliwanag ang ating mga tungkulin araw-araw.
Please stand.
God never intended us to die. He created us for life, but we chose death. Christ, our Redeemer, restores us to life, and we come to our Father praying through Him. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our Pope and bishops may continue to proclaim the good news of Christ's resurrection, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government officials may imitate the compassion and gentleness of Jesus in caring for the least of his brethren, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people in nations afflicted by poverty may be drawn to Jesus, who became poor for our sake, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who find life burdensome may see God's special love and care through the concern of their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may be raised up to eternal joy in heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and for all the intentions offered in this Mass. We continue to lift up to the Lord as well our prayers for one another. For all of these we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All-powerful God, our lives rest in your hand. Trusting in your provident care, we bring our petitions before you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Inakaya ko
Please stand.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We invite you tonight for our Wednesday family rosary, and the host for tonight will be from the community and parish of Santa Teresita from West Rembo, Taguig City. We continue to gather as a family and ask the intercession of the Blessed Mother to pray for us and accompany each and every one of us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.